Today, we are testing and unboxing a Topdon OBD meter, the OBDCAN Elite. Ooh, Elite. This one's a little more advanced than the last one I tested for you guys at the launch. This one has enhanced OBD mode 6, read DTCs, clear DTCs, read data stream, turn off mill and reset monitors, view freeze frame data, readiness monitor status, display O2 sensor test data, and read vehicle information, DTC lookup, test data review, read and clear DTCs and ABS. Take a breath in between there. And DTC lookup, test data review, I read that already. SRS, supports multilingual interface, and it is internet upgradable. Awesome. Also supports a 2.8-inch TFT screen, 320 by 240 resolution. It can operate on input voltage of 9 to 18 volts. So it doesn't matter if you have a practically dead battery or it's producing a little too much. Your standard 16-pin connection. A power consumption only 1.8 watts, so if you're trying to monitor something over a long period of time, no problem, great working temperature, you're pretty much all set. But you don't want to hear me just reading from the box. You want to see me open the box up. So let's take a look. This is not my vehicle. It is a 2002 Nissan. Why am I saying Nissan? Maybe because I own a 2002 Nissan. My old truck. But this is not my old truck. This is a 2002 Lincoln Navigator. Extremely worn out vehicle. It has beat the living crap. So, what better vehicle to test it in? So, the Topdon reader comes in this awesome durable. Hey, I like this. This is the same kind of case that my Mavic drone came in. Very durable case. Foam filled. So let's pull this bugger out. Awesome. A nice long reader cable. Let's take some of the twist ties off of there. There we go. Oh, wow. Some of these are like so short. You know, you're trying to read it, especially if you're monitoring something while it's in operation. Let's take off the little screen protection. Get rid of that. Let's just do a quick once over of the unit. We have the OBD connection. Very nice looking screen. So can't wait to see how it is in operation. On the side here, you have your USB and a SD memory card, which probably contains all the upgradable data. It is a SanDisk. Wow, 4 gig SanDisk. Put that back in there before I lose it. Diagnostic standard. All right, I'm going to plug this in. Remove the... I had a car lock in here so I could track this vehicle. And I just can't see that plug. There we go. Okay. Oh, it's powering on. System is starting. We'll let it start. In the meantime, it's running up there. Let's see what else is in here. Pretty much straightforward. You got a USB cable. Mini USB cable. And... here is a micro USB adapter, or not micro USB, micro SD memory card to USB adapter, so you can take that SD card out for updates. And you got the owner's manual, but we don't look at owner's manuals. No, that's no fun. So let's zoom in a little closer and see what we got here. All right, I got the car or truck started now. And we have OBD diagnose, review data, tool setup, and help. This is the screen that comes on immediately after I plugged it in. I'm going to go out on a limb without reading the directions here and think that maybe the up and down arrows are for up and down. Let's start off with tool setup. Take a look. Language, well, we're obviously in English. Also has French and Spanish. Espanol. Units of measure. We're in the U.S., so we want imperial. Yes, we're backwards. I much prefer metric for everything but distance. I just can't get the hang of metric for distance. Record mode? Off. Okay. Okay. Alright, let's go up. Might as well just scan. Should we see if there's any trouble? Vehicle? Lincoln. Well, there is no Lincoln. Or Ford. Oh, USA Ford. There we go. Well, since USA and Ford, same company, we'll just go with the Ford, which should be just fine. Checking files. Please wait. Gotta have a little drink here. Nope, nothing found. Let's go back. OBD diagnose. Oh, I get it. There's no codes found, so nothing came up. Monitor status. Check that out. We got, let's see. Readiness completed. Data stream supported. Okay. Read codes. There we go. Vehicle has no fault codes. Wow, that's rare. Usually this thing's always got problems. So nothing to erase. Let's see. Readiness. This drive cycle. Well, there are no codes. Data stream. Let's check out some live raw data. Cool. Check that out. Fuel system status. That's all good. Calculated load. Oh, whoops. Calculated load value, 36.5%. Watch what happens when I press the accelerator. Now, the engine is cold and warming up. And this thing stinks, too. Needs a catalytic converter. Engine coolant temperature, 98 degrees. Let's see. Fuel trim. I have no idea what that means. Engine RPM, which basically matches identically with what's on the dash. Vehicle speed, 0. Yes, we're definitely not moving. Ignition timing. Now, that's a good thing to know. So if you're, say you're pulling a heavy load like a trailer, knowing your ignition timing comes in really handy. As it can kind of tell you, you know, how stressed out your engine is, and especially if you're running a lower octane fuel. The airflow rate. Throttle position. Cool. Oxygen sensor output. Short-term fuel trim. I'm gonna have to look that up. It's been too long since I've worked with gas vehicles. Let's see. It shows all the oxygen sensors. Cool. Let's go back. Oh, wait. Graphic items. Let's see what this comes up with. Calculated load value. Hey, let's try. Yeah, let's do load. Let's see how that looks. And I screwed that up. Alright, so then I press. Oh, there we go. I see what I did wrong. There was a little, I was actually checking and unchecking things. That would be then graphed out. So I'm going to give a little Excel. You can see the spike there. Cool. Freeze frame. O2 sensor test. Hey, let's try that. Bank one. Oh, this vehicle doesn't support onboard monitoring. Cool. Info there. Test values. Don't know if this is going to end up being the same. Pretty much. EVAP system test. Oh, see if you overfill your. Oh, leak test failed. Guess what that means? It means Grandpa has overfilled his gas tank a few too many times and probably got his EVAP canister full of fuel, ruining it, the charcoal. Okay, fail. Let's try this again. Vehicle information, let's try that. Got the VIN number, calibration, identifications. Not too bad. Well, it's a neat little chart, little scanner. Oh. Let's see. Oh, that was diagnosed. Let's try review data. Review data stream. No recorded data. Well, I guess if you record it, you can go back and check. But, DCC library, tool information. Cool. Topdon.us. So, if you are interested in a no BS, easy to use and easy to read scanner, even easier to use after you read the directions, give this one a try. Purchase link is in the description box below. And if you have questions, I'll try my best to answer. But I don't usually name prices, so I'm not going to. But the price that this was at was marketed as pretty fair. A lot better quality than your Harbor Freights. And internet updatable. So when the updates come out, let's turn this nasty, stinky beast off. Safety precautions, introduction, codes. Well, we didn't have any codes. Let's see, internet updatable. Only available in UltraScan. Well, it looks like we got the internet updatable version. Let's see. Oh, let's stick to English directions. Even has a little, the flow charts make your scans a little easier. Always better to read the directions, but we don't read directions here, right? That's why you're watching this video. If you want to update, you just go to topdon.us, download the update tool to the computer, uncompress and install on your computer. Compatible with XP 7, Windows 8, and Windows 10. Awesome. After installation, connect the tool to the USB port on the computer, and the screen displays as followed. Launch the update tool. A screen similar to figure 7-2 will pop out. Choose desired interface and then click device update to enter update center. Choose software version and then click update to start updating. Once update is complete, an upgrade success message box will pop up. Ba-bing! Pretty damn simple. Or you can even just do it straight to the memory card, apparently. Be cool to duplicate the memory card, or you can make an extra one. Why? I really don't know, because why would you be taking it in and out too much? You will have to enter your serial number and update away. Cool. You also get a register code that will display on the screen of your unit. So once again, that is all. I mean, it's a OBD scanner, a great little one. Looks fairly reliable and fairly durable, too. USB, updatable, right off the internet, so no headaches there. And let's get a real good look at this screen. And here's a big problem with a lot of the cheap units, is the screen is just horrible. And now, usually, also, if you're trying to show a screen by using a camcorder to record it, it turns out horrible as well. But take a look. This screen is really good. It's a TFT. You don't get that contrast issues you get with some of the lower quality, the cheaper ones. I mean, it's perfect. Easy to read. Sunlight, daylight. Pull up my 1000 lumen flashlight, which is a little dead, but you can see it even with the flashlight. Big problem if you're with some of these lower quality ones, they cheap out on the screen and you just can't read the damn things. So I've already wasted 18 minutes of your time. If you're interested in purchasing, purchase links below. If not,